do the lighting and everything else. Why don't you get on your phone and text about 5-10 people out and say we're getting ready to do a Bible study. And if I had to give it a title, I would say just decide. You know, we make decisions every single day. What do I wear? What am I going to eat? Where do I want to live? Am I going to date this person? Do I want to marry them? Do I take this job? Because your decisions actually determine your destiny. Now, the first thing you need to know is there's a difference between destiny and purpose. Purpose is your supreme reason for being. It's the intention, the choice, the decision that God has made about you. And God has a great purpose for you. But it's our decisions, our daily decisions, that determine our destiny. So I want you to text out about 20 people, and I want to help you on making great decisions. And I want to give you probably about 7 or 10 pointers today. Things like when you don't make a decision, or, you know, when you derail some things, how do you get back on track? So hope you're having a beautiful, beautiful Sunday. So happy to be with you today. And remember, you'll see Paula White Ministries on there that'll tell you how to connect with us on the web and how to get the new product that's out. So many exciting things are happening today. We had a powerful time in church. And thank you guys for praying. I just had a little bit of foot surgery, so we filmed the whole thing. It's going to be pretty wild. But anyway, I did it because I want to have a shoe line. I couldn't fit in like 80% of my shoes, and I've been having foot pain forever. So Dr. Brody is an amazing doctor. He said, okay, you can do this, or in 5 years from now, you're going to be forced to. And he's like, we got to reconstruct your foot. So it's pretty crazy. They broke it in 5 places and took the sides off and lengthened the tendons. But the thing is, I have a brand new foot. And he said, I have the strongest bones he's ever worked with. He goes, you're going to live to be like 100 years old. I said, absolutely. So you ready? I've got a word for you. Let's go over to Proverbs. Proverbs, love you guys. Good to see you, Sierra. Good to see everyone. And thank you for supporting Paula White Ministries. If you want to be a blessing to our ministry, we are always doing something to spread the gospel. We've been working with the hurricane victims. We continue to preach the word around the world. We're getting ready to build a brand new studio here at New Destiny Christian Center. They come in tomorrow, so we're excited about that. Launching some new series this year. Hopefully, prayerfully launching the internet network in the middle of writing my memoir, my book right now, which comes out next September, Something Greater. God has something greater for you. Ready? Proverbs chapter 14, verse 8. I want to talk to you about how do I make good decisions? How do I make mature decisions? Decisions that are not going to derail my life, but decisions that are going to keep me right in the purpose and the plan of God. Because if God has a purpose for me, I'm deciding. Now, decision comes from a Latin word, a root word of to cut. So it literally has a lot to do with what you're willing to cut away, what you're willing to cut out of your life, what you're willing to let go of. So when you decide, it's from that root of being able to cut through, cut away. And I want you to keep that in mind. Proverbs chapter 14, verse 8, I'm going to use 2 key scriptures along with Proverbs chapter 22, verse 3. It says, the wisdom of the prudent is to give thought to their ways. Your way is your course of life or your course of action. But the folly of fools is deception. So watch what he's saying. The wisdom of the prudent is to give thought to their ways, to make good decisions. But the folly of fools is deception. And we know that James says, a man that looks in the word and reads it and looks at it like a mirror, beholds himself but turns away and keeps going his own way, it's like, you know, he's foolish. He calls it that man a fool, he said, because he's lying to himself. Because if you look at the word is your mirror. It will reflect truth to you. The word is truthful. It is flawless. It is perfect. So let's look at Proverbs chapter 22, verse 3, both talking about being prudent. It says, a prudent man sees danger and takes refuge, but the simple keep going and suffer for it. So think about this. A prudent man sees danger and takes refuge, but a simple man keeps going and suffers for it. Now, that can be in relationships. That can be with a job. That can be in ministry. That can be in, you know, who you hang around. That can be your environment. A prudent man sees danger. This relationship is going to be detrimental for me. You know, all of us, well, I can't say all of us, but a lot of us have been in some bad relationships that took from us, took emotionally, took physically, took financially. They weren't ordained by God. A prudent man sees danger, watch, and takes refuge. But the simple keep going and suffer for it. So a prudent man sees that job might look good. It might look like it's right, but it could be dangerous. It's going to lead me down. It might look good to go hang out with my friends. It might look good to be around this person. It might look good to move into this neighborhood. It might look good. You know how many people buy a house or move into a neighborhood and never really seek God or pray over it? And you have no idea spiritually what that, you know, maybe it was not dedicated to God. It was, you know, dedicated to demonic worship, or maybe it was built on land that there's a lot of bloodshed or something. People just say, oh, that's a beautiful house. I've got to have it. You know, the prudent, it says this, sees danger, has the ability to have revelation and takes refuge, but the simple keep going and suffer for it. So prudent means this, exercising sound judgment. So the wisdom of the prudent is to give thought to their ways, but the folly of the fools is deception. A prudent man sees danger and takes refuge, but the simple keep going and suffer for it. So prudent means I exercise sound judgment. So how do I get sound judgment? It means I'm making mature and wise decisions. When you make mature decisions or sound decisions, you decide to make choices that have to do with your coming complete, your wholeness, with you being in alignment with God's word. Just decide. I don't always feel it. I will it. So sometimes you've got to will what's right. Never make decisions that are detrimental to your growth. Don't ever make decisions that are detrimental to or against what God has to say in his word, because that's not prudent. That's not sound judgment. Sin brings forth death. Sin means to miss the mark. Weigh every decision against what God has to say in his word, which would also be what your prophetic future. What does God say? Not what is your current condition, because your current condition will change, because it's not stronger than what God has to say in his word. So God says, you're blessed coming in, you're blessed going in. You're the head and not the tail. God says that you're fearfully and wonderfully created, that you're an heir with God and a joint heir with Jesus Christ. God says you're the apple of his eye. God says he is ever mindful of you. God says that he will give you power to get wealth. He gives you an anointing to get wealth, which is much more than money. God says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. God says, no weapon formed against you will be able to prosper. God said, he raises one up and he sits another down. Promotion doesn't come from the south, the east, the west, according to Psalm chapter 75. God said, he encompasses you, according to Psalm 74, with a shield of glory. God says in Psalm 68:19 that he loads you up daily with his benefits. So you want to make decisions. God says that there's power of life and death in your words. You want to make decisions based upon his word. Heaven and earth pass away, but the word shall remain forever. So when you make mature decisions, you decide to make choices that have to do with you coming, becoming complete, becoming whole, becoming who God says you are, not based on your current relationship, your current bank account, your current home, your current status, your current situation. So the wisdom of the prudent is to give thought to their ways. Now, prudence is exercising sound judgment. And a prudent man sees danger and takes refuge, but the simple keep going and they suffer for it. So when you're prudent and you exercise sound judgment, it's a decision that's reached through discernment by evaluation. It's also the ability to make right decisions during tough times. You know, they say, what is the saying, like, tough times don't last, but tough people do. So think about this. A prudent man exercises sound judgment so they can make right decisions during difficult times, during tough times. So you don't cave into culture. You don't cave into the circumstance. You don't cave into peer pressure. So let's look a part of just something real quick. I'll give you a few right now. and then let's pray together and talk together. Part of a mature decision making is knowing when not to make a decision. You see, not making a decision is still making a decision. So indecision is still a decision. But when don't you decide? There's things like acronyms we use called HALT. When you're hungry, when you're angry, when you're lonely, when you're tired. You remember that HALT. If I'm hungry, if I'm angry, if I'm lonely, I'm tired. I don't make a major life decision. When you're discouraged, because discouragement sometimes leads to depression, and your mind's not thinking in a right mode. When you're not walking close with God, when the heavens are shut, don't make a permanent decision in a temporary situation. So there are those seasons, like if you're backslidden, you can come back to Christ Jesus. I mean, you might have taken 100 steps away from him, but you're one step back to him. I use it again when you're hurting, angry, lonely, tired. Don't make it when you're lonely, like when you're away from your environment that is safe, where you feel valued and validated. If you're sick, you're angry. When you're being tempted, you might go, my God, she's so beautiful. He's the best thing in the world. But hold up. There is safety in the multitude of counsel. Don't make it when you're being impatient. So a key to right decisions is right relationships. You have to have good people around you. It says Proverbs chapter 24, verse 21 through 22. My son, fear thou the Lord and the King, and meddle not with them that are given to change. For their calamity shall arise suddenly, and who knoweth the ruin of them both? So you want to watch who you're around, you know, who's your prayer partner, who do you hang out with, who's your homie. Be careful, because the Bible says that you can be around, basically, I like how Henry Drummond says it. He says that you become a product of what you're around, and that you are basically the five people that you hang around the most. You're the mosaic of all men that you're around. So make sure that you get the right people around you. 2 Corinthians 6, 14 through 18 talks a lot about being not unequally yoked. So I just want to share some things before I tell you how to make the right decisions. Don't make it when you're hungry, angry, lonely, tired. You know, when you're discouraged, when you're despondent, when you're depressed, distressed. Don't make a permanent decision in a temporary situation. Sometimes people think, I just can't live without this, but I want to pray over you right now, because there are a lot of things we can't live without. So let's pray together, community. Amen. Let's see. Put your prayer request up. Remember, if you want to be a partner of Paula White Ministry or donate, you can do so. Use your phone. Simply text PWM 45777. Thank you. Love bringing an inspirational word. What a blessing it is to be with you. Bad company ruins good character. So true. Go back, and thanks for sharing. So I was out this past week because I had foot surgery. Thank you guys for being patient with me and for praying. I am praying for you, praying for your business right now. Let's pray together. Father, we lift up, and I ask that you would allow everyone that has an ear to hear to be prudent in their decisions, to have sound judgment, that they would not make a wrong decision in regards to a relationship, in regards to relocation, in regards to a job, in regards to their environment, buying a home. Our decisions determine our destiny. So I pray that you would give them the mind of Christ according to Philippians chapter 2, verse 5. I pray that their mind would be renewed according to Romans chapter 12, verse 1 and 2, that we're not conformed to this world, but we're transformed by the renewing, renovation of our mind, taking out the old and putting in the new. I ask, God, that you would give us the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, and that you would remove every weight that so easily besets us, that we would lay it aside according to the book of Hebrews, chapter 12, verse 1, that we would have an ability to run with you. I pray for every person that's discouraged, that has an ungodly or demonic burden upon them, that right now you would lift that demonic burden. There is an anointing that destroys every yoke. Let the yoke be destroyed. Let the anointing go through this phone right now and touch every person right now that is bearing a burden that does not belong on them. In the name which is above every name, the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I command depression, suicidal thoughts, generational curses, fear, doubt, unbelief to be lifted off of you, poverty to be broken off you right now in Jesus' name. For everything that is causing you to walk in low self-esteem or despondency, let it be lifted. For everything that is causing you to be weary, to lose your sense of pleasure, let it be lifted right now in the mighty matchless name of Jesus. And I pray right now that the Lord give you joy, joy that you will no longer be drained or you won't be despondent or distressed, but you'll be able to make good decisions. Let sickness be overturned, for he was wounded according to Isaiah chapter 53. He was wounded for your transgression, bruised for your iniquity. The chastisement of your peace is upon him, and with his stripes you are healed. Let every physical calamity upon your body, let the healing power of God flow through your body right now in Jesus' name. Let your heart be mended. Whatever is causing your heart to be sick, to ache, whether it is the loss of a loved one, whatever grief, we command the spirit of grief to leave you right now. I ask for full restoration, that what the enemy came and stole from you, that God would restore to you sevenfold. Let your family come back together. We send angels to the north, the south, the east, the west to locate our children, Father, and to bring them back into the family of God. Send an angel, send ministers to minister to them and open their eyes, remove every veil, that the seeds that have been planted, there will be people that come along and water them, that you will send ministering angels to minister to them, that they will be saved in Jesus' name. I declare household salvation, just like you did it for Cornelius, and it came over to the Gentiles. I declare household salvation. Let people, even now, let them begin to pray and call out their children's name as Cornelius gave of alms, and because he was a righteous man that gave alms and he prayed. And there are people even now that are standing with Paula White Ministry that said, yes, I'll become a partner. Yes, you keep preaching. Paula, you've been to over 100 countries. You preach potentially to millions of people. We're on Impact Network. We're on so many different television stations. We're continually producing videos. We're everywhere. Just go to Paula White website and figure it all out and find it out. Constantly subscribe to the YouTube channel. But maybe you want to stand and partner. You can easily do so by donating using your phone. Simply text PWM 4577 and stand with us. I come in agreement that your dream, your destiny will come to pass in Jesus' name. Love you guys.